recently, you know, I started doing one activity with my students, and I found it that my students are enjoying that activity. I just want to share that with you. I just take some random pictures, okay, and then I tell my students, I show them that picture, and then right after 30 seconds, I ask them, how did that happen? And when did that happen? I ask, like, they have to react in a way that they are the one who know everything about that picture.
Okay.
So they have to explain that picture like they were there when that picture was taken. Okay, then they can make a story. They make up a story, and they seem to be enjoying. They seem to enjoy that particular activity. Yeah.
What kind of photos do you use? Like, what kind of situations or?
Okay. Well, can I share the screen with you?
Sure. Go for it.
Pictures. Yeah.
I love the idea of the story of this game.
Yeah. Usually, I take the, you know, I usually choose the funny pictures.
I do something similar where I ask my students to bring a photo and then explain it to the class. But I think it's much more fun if the students have to be creative and use their own imagination, right?
So I will ask my student after showing it to them that how did this happen and when did this happen? Then they have to come up with a story. They have to make up a story. It would be, you know, 2 to 3 minute long story,
Yeah, they can make a long story about suddenly someone got stuck in a chair and had to go to the hospital or anything. It's limited to their imagination, and I bet every student tells a different story.
You know, we can ask our students to be creative, okay? And they have to convince me. Like, they have to convince their teachers how good they are with their stories and all that.
That's amazing. I really like that.
One of the pictures, yeah.
There's another game that I play if I've got like a group of students, if I've got a class, right? So say, for example, you show them that photo and they have to tell a story. But at any time, I open up someone's mic. Everybody is muted. And if I open your mic, you have to continue with the story. And the students don't know who I'm going to click on. So they're all like thinking about what can they talk about. So they start a story. For example, in that case, the lady was sitting in a chair and suddenly she got stuck. And then I switch to another student and they have to continue the story and continue and continue. It's a really fun way of keeping them engaged. And they also have fun telling the story and continuing the story because they build it together. So I like doing something like that too. Well, I just want to say thank you so much for helping me with that, with this, and also sharing that great game.
You too, Eric. Thank you so much for your time, and it's a great learning. And I would love to join more. I would say, like in future, I would like to join you again. Yeah, for sure.
Definitely, you've got amazing ideas, and I think a lot of people can learn from it. Rohit, have a great day, have a good night, and I'll see you soon.
You too. Take care, Eric. Bye-bye.